Some people tap their feet, some people snap their fingers, and some people just sway back and forth. I just sort of do them all together, I guess.
And now here is Elvis Presley.
I can't lose you, baby.
So excited, I could just, oh, I can't wait.
I think Presley was a star.
Well, how's the news?
Oh, he's such a sexy person.
He will always be the king, no matter what.
Hello, everybody. In this video, I have all the ingredients to keep you informed for about 20 minutes or so. I have details about an upcoming box set, the Clothier to the King, chart positions, short news flashes, an epic failure, a fever blister, and the three most important things for a fan. That is, coffee, sex, and Elvis. It doesn't get much better than that. My name is Emiel Maier, and you are watching the Elvis Presley News Report of September 2022. A 5-inch Elvis on Tour box set with 6 CDs and 1 Blu-ray is due for release on December 2nd, 2022. The set with a price tag of $109 includes the audio of 4 shows and 2 rehearsals that were part of the 1972 documentary Elvis on Tour. Disc 1 is the fantastic show of April 9 at Hampton Roads Coliseum, Virginia. Disc 2 is the live show at Richmond Coliseum, Virginia on April 10. Disc 3 was recorded on April 14 at the Greensboro Coliseum in North Carolina. And to conclude the live shows part of the set, Disc 4 was recorded at the Convention Center in San Antonio, Texas on April 18, 1972. The set is mixed by Memphis-based Grammy Award-winning producer Matt Ross Spang. The liner notes are written by Jerry Schilling. The set features a total of 145 tracks, including 91 tracks that have never been released before. In the past month, some professional shot footage of Elvis' show in San Diego on November 15, 1970 appeared on the internet. The images are very clear, but there is no sound. I may be mistaken, but I think we are looking at an identical pose of Elvis that was used for the sleeve of the 1970s Walk a Mile in My Shoes box set. 8 weeks after the release of the Elvis movie of Baz Luhrmann, the movie has grossed $263 million. The movie is still showing in more than 2,200 American cinemas, and it has entered the top 10 of best performing movies of 2022. That is an amazing achievement. In the United Kingdom, the soundtrack of the Elvis movie jumped to the number one spot in the official soundtrack albums chart top 50. In the week of August 13, the Elvis soundtrack is at number 26 in the Billboard 200. Perhaps even more spectacular was the giant leap of the soundtrack on the regular album chart in Australia. On the official area chart, the soundtrack of the movie jumps from 102 in the previous week to number 4.
This collection, Colonel's wife had. Luann Parker. Luann Parker passed, and a certain person had taken it and kept it away and hid it for a while. And we found it, and because of that, it's all laid out and all exposed now. Colonel did not like jewelry, did not wear jewelry, and Elvis was always giving him jewelry. And this is part of that collection. Now, he may have worn it maybe when Elvis was around every once in a while, but yes, Elvis picked them out himself, and I think that's the most important part for me, is that he actually picked the rings out or the pieces out. I want people, fans, people who love it, know that it is authentic. There's so much product out there that is not authentic at all, and that worries me. I don't want fans or people buying things that people say that it's Elvis's or Elvis worn it, when there's so many of that And I got involved because I want to know for sure that that is going to someone who's going to care for it, love it, and it's authentic.
These were the very first rock and roll cufflinks, and this is a multi-million dollar business for people nowadays, and we have the very first ones.
Not all of the 191 items that are auctioned are of the Colonel's jewelry collection. Of the other items, I like to focus onto two very expensive lots. The first one is the 1976 Harley-Davidson FLH 1200 Electra Glide, as this was sold for $800,000 in 2019, making it the third most expensive Harley-Davidson in the world. The second lot of interest to me is the 68 Comeback Special Hagstrom V2 guitar. This guitar was bought by guitarist Steve Stevens for $500,000 in 2021. Please note that this was the hammer price without the 25% buyer's premium. So he had to pay $625,000 to the auction house. Steve Stevens gifted the guitar to his friend Billy Idol, but now it is back on the auction block with a minimum asking price of $750,000. Please come back next month for the result of this auction. I want to show you my most precious and special Elvis item. It is this 40 by 60 inches movie poster of GI Blues. Now, these 40 by 60 inches movie posters were always shipped to the cinemas rolled in a tube. I think to save on space and making it easier to stack, the original owner of this movie poster decided at a certain moment to fold it. Despite the creases that were caused due to the folding, I decided to buy it and I had the movie poster restored. You can still see where it was folded, but it doesn't stand out. I have never seen a similar poster being offered for sale or on auctions. It is just a wild guess, but I think perhaps five have survived. If you have the exact same 40 by 60 inches GI Blues movie poster, then please reach out to me. There is one movie poster that I still want to buy, and that is the 40 by 60 inches movie poster of Blue Hawaii. Once I found this poster with water damage on the American Craigslist in 2013. It was being offered by University Pawn and Jewelry in Florida. But the owner did not want to ship it to me. He only accepted cash payment in person at his shop. So it stopped for me there. So dear viewers, if you have one, or know people who have one, then please contact me. Priscilla made an epic mistake during her speech prior to the candlelight vigil of August 15. It wasn't just a slip of the tongue. I mean, when you talk to thousands of people, you have to be prepared. This was so embarrassing, and perhaps time has come for her to take a step back.
This is a very special day celebrating his birthday. Elvis never really liked to celebrate his birthday. He always loved celebrating other people's birthday. So this is our chance to give him a big hug and celebrate him and say, happy birthday, Elvis. Happy birthday, Elvis! Yeah, he's probably closes his eyes.
Now it is time for some viewer participation, as I want to see the most special Elvis item in your collection. In case you want to share it with the rest of my viewers, then make 5 different photos of the item and write 5 sentences and send it to elvisdisco@hotmail.com. Let me help you with those 5 accompanying sentences. 1. What is your most special Elvis item? 2. Where did you get it? 3. Why is it so special? And add 2 more sentences with information you would like to share about the item. It doesn't have to be something expensive. It may also be an Elvis drawing of your child or just a regular CD that has a special meaning to you. I am looking forward to all your reactions. On August 8th, singer Olivia Newton-John passed at the age of 73. Elvis covered two of her big hits, Let Me Be There and If You Love Me, Let Me Know, both live in concert.
This next song is a song that was recorded by Olivia Newton-John, and it's called If You Love Me, Let Me Know, and If You Don't, Then Move It.
Olivia Newton-John also performed O Come All Ye Faithful on Elvis's 2008 Christmas Duets release. We will always remember Olivia Newton-John from her role as Sandy in the 1978 hit movie Grease. Nancy Brooks started working at Graceland in May of 1967 as a cook and a maid, and was at Graceland on the day that Elvis died. After Elvis's death, she continued working at Graceland. She wrote two books, Inside Graceland and the Presley Family Cookbook. Nancy Brooks died on August 15, 2022 at the age of 84. Hello there, viewers. Now, while we are waiting for the coffee, we have to talk because the numbers of my Elvis news videos have dropped dramatically. Last year I had between 12 to 15,000 views per month, which is very high, but nowadays I'm really struggling to even reach 7,000 views. Now, if a video maker really makes a big effort, then I'm more than happy for this person if he or she gets lots of views. But I do get a bit angry when I see clips like, for instance, Elvis eats a hamburger, scoring massive numbers. The reason why I feel this way is because those clips are a simple copy-paste job from an existing movie like That's the Way It Is. Now, the lack in progress is very discouraging, as I put so many hours and effort in making my videos. I have looked for an explanation and I have found a way of looking at the matter. Come, let's go to the studio. Now, an explanation can be that due to COVID-19, more people were at home and therefore more on YouTube in the past 2 years. On the other hand, I also ask myself, how do I measure the success of my channel? I used to look at the number of views, but now I am more focused on the reactions. It is really great to see how well my videos are being received, and the people who do watch are highly appreciative. That really gives me a boost. But having said that, I wouldn't mind if I would receive more views in the future, because if I can only reach 5,000 people, then it's probably time to start looking for another hobby. So please spread the word about my channel, and if you haven't subscribed yet, then do it now. Thank you very much. Goodbye. I'd like to take this opportunity to express my gratitude to the teams behind Elvis InfoNet and Elvis Day by Day for supporting my videos in the past years. I heartily recommend their sites to my viewers. So go and check them out.
I'm Hal Lansky, second generation owner. Lansky's at the Peabody.
Pop that collar, get a little attitude going.
We're also known as the Clother to the King, and this is Elvis Week.
There you go, man. The mirror's looking at you. Streets want you.
The crowds are awesome. Of course, you know, with the pandemic the last couple of years, we haven't had any international travelers, so they're coming in droves.
Y'all from Germany?
Yeah.
We're hearing a little French, a little Spanish, a little whatever.
Amazing to think that Elvis came here and bought his clothes, and there we are doing exactly the same thing.
Lansky's is amazing. It's my first time visiting.
I just feel privileged to be here because not many people get the chance to be here.
This is what I love about Lansky's.
Yeah. It's beautiful.
Lansky's has always represented style. It's embedded in rock and roll history, just like Sun Studios and Memphis and Graceland and everything else.
A lot of people ask us how my dad met Elvis, and this goes back to 1952, midsummer, when he saw this young man looking in the window. He said, "Come on in, young man," and this young man back then was a nobody, and this young man said, "Mr. Lansky, I don't have any money, but one of these days I'm going to come buy you out." And Mr. Lansky, my dad, said, "Young man, don't buy me out, just buy from me." And that's what started the friendship, and in later years, this young man turned out to be the greatest entertainer of all times, Elvis Presley. You could probably see a framed photo of me as like an 8-year-old young man standing next to Elvis. And my dad was known as the Clother to the King, but my title was the Delivery Boy to the King. I used to deliver stuff out to Graceland, and you know, Elvis loved clothes, and a lot of times he just said, "I'll take it all."
Hello everybody, it's trivia time, and to boost up the views of my video, I have decided to turn to the cheapest marketing trick in the book, and that is sex sells. And I'm not talking about Boots Randolph, baby. I am going to give you the answer to last month's trivia question, but in a totally different setting, because with a snap of my finger, I can change the backdrop of the video. And you guys may now be annoyed that my head is in your view, but therefore I will swing from left to right when I give the answer to last month's trivia question. Okay, I ask what a fuzzy tree is. The fuzzy tree is not a species of trees. Some trees in the southern states and Mexico are regularly infested by hairy caterpillars called the fall webworm. Are you still with me? The hairs of which contain a mild poison and will cause an itchy rash. These trees are called fuzzy trees if they are infested by thousands of caterpillars who have spun their silken webs. But oh, stop! This is not right. Let's cut with this cheap marketing tool, as I do not want to lose my beloved female viewers. So with a snap of my fingers, we have left the corridor. Sorry, ladies. Let me make it up to you. With a snap of my fingers, we are in another corridor. Not bad. And the trivia question is only for you. Oh, you want me to get out of the way. Okay, like I said, the trivia question is only for you, ladies. But I'm going to play you two snippets of songs, really tiny snippets. And with a little imagination, girls, you have imagination, you get a new song title. So just listen and place your answer in the comments below. Good luck! Bye! That's all for this month. Hope to see you next time. Until then, have a happy Elvis Presley Day. You have a happy